What's up internet, welcome back once again. I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and I'm back with another PLC quill tutorial. Today we will learn how to create an instead of insert trigger in Oracle database. With the previous tutorial, we are finished with learning about database event triggers and how to create different types of them. Hope you enjoyed watching those tutorials. Now it's time to jump over to the next type of triggers in Oracle database, which are instead of triggers. So without further ado, let's get started. Using instead of trigger, you can control the default behavior of insert, update, delete, and merge operation on views, but not on tables. Yes, you heard it right. You can write an instead of trigger on views only and not on tables in Oracle database. That is a restriction you have to comply with. God knows why, but that's how it works. Anyways, let's move ahead. So now you must be wondering, what is the use of instead of triggers in Oracle database? Since an instead of trigger can only be used with views, therefore we can use them to make a non-updatable view updatable, as well as to override the default behavior of views that are updatable. I can understand your concern, but don't be confused. You will understand everything when we will do the example for instead of triggers. But before that, let's quickly see the syntax of instead of triggers in Oracle database. So here is the syntax, which is pretty simple. First line is similar to every other trigger which we have seen so far. It starts with keyword create and an optional clause or replace, using which we can alter the definition of already created trigger, followed by keyword trigger, which specifies to the compiler what object we are going to create. And then we have the name of the trigger. This concludes the first line of the syntax. In the second line, we have reserve phrase instead of, followed by operation, which could be either one of insert, update, delete, or merge. In the next line, we have to supply the name of the view using the keyword on over which you want your trigger to work. Next, we have for each row clause, which makes your trigger execute once for each row that is inserted, updated, or deleted from the underlying view. Then we have the PLSQL block. So this is the syntax for the instead of trigger in Oracle database. As we have now understood the syntax, so let's go ahead and do an example. In this example, I will demonstrate how to create an instead of insert trigger in Oracle database. As I said above, that using instead of trigger, we can make a non-updatable view updatable. Let's see what does that mean. So what will I do? First, I will create two tables and then I will create a view over these tables. So first, let's do that. Here we have two tables. Both the tables have only one column. It's just for the sake of simplicity and to make the process of instead of trigger creation easy to understand. Now, let's insert some values into these two tables. One row of data in each table, I guess, will be enough for the demonstration. Next, I will create a view which will join both these tables and will show you the combined result. In order to better understand the concepts of SQL views, I highly encourage you to watch the SQL tutorial 60. There I explain the concepts of views in detail. Link is in the description. Before writing the view, let's close this script output and clear the screen. So here we have our view. This view is not updatable. You can check that by inserting a row in this view or into the underlying tables used in this view. Let's do one thing. Let's try to insert a row into this view and see what happens. As you can see, we have an error here, which indicates that this view is not at all updatable. But as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, that using instead of trigger, we can make a non-updatable view updatable. Now it's time to check as to what extent this statement holds true. And for that, we will have to write an instead of trigger on this view. Let's do it. But before that, let's close this script output. Okay, great. Now let's write the trigger. Here we are. Trigger is fairly simple. In the first line, you can see that the name of our trigger is tr underscore io underscore insert. You can give whatever name you want to your trigger. Second line starts with the reserved phrase instead of, followed by the operation on which you want your trigger to work. In our case, the operation is insert. Then using on keyword, we specified the name of the view which we just created. Then we have for each row clause, which makes sure that this trigger will execute for every single row which will be inserted. Followed by that, we have our PLSQL block where we have two insert DMLs using which we are inserting values into the tables. These insert DMLs will fetch the data from the insert statement, which will execute over the view and insert the respective values into the underlying tables from the mentioned view. Let's execute and compile this trigger. Trigger compiled successfully. Now let's try to execute the same insert statement once again and see whether it works this time or not. One row inserted. Both the values have been inserted into their respective tables. You can check. Let's close this script output first. Now let's check. Here is the entry Manish. Let's try the subject table. And here is the Java. That is how you can make a non-updatable view updatable using instead of trigger. In the next tutorial, we will see how to create instead of trigger on an update statement. Before winding up this tutorial, I have something to say. I received a lot of questions from you regarding certification, programming, career, YouTube, social media, and on various other topics. I am planning to answer them, and for that, I have created a separate YouTube channel. As you can see, I have already uploaded a video which is a giveaway. You can win this giveaway, but for that you have to watch the video. Meanwhile, if you have any question, feel free to send it to me. All my contact details are in description below. Also, make sure to subscribe to my second YouTube channel. That's it for today. Hope you learned something and enjoyed watching. Please make sure to give this video a thumbs up and help others in learning by sharing this video on your social media or by any means you find convenient. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.